One aspect I think we've not covered yet is about women journalists and the kind of issues they face. Because as it is, Kashmir is a conservative society. Women find it very difficult to work at unconventional jobs. And especially freelance journalism is a precarious and not very secure job financially as well as physically. Yet there are about 7 or 8 working journalists who are very, very active, even during the blockade, going out, telling stories. And these are the people we saw in action, working despite all the odds, despite family disapproval, despite actual physical insecurity. And in fact, 2 days ago on Sunday, one woman journalist who we knew actually was intimidated, confined to her car, yelled at and screamed at by the security forces. And this is the kind of atmosphere they're operating in. Yet it's the women journalists also who have been able to break stories about what women there are going through. And, you know, this is a state which has one of the highest number of enforced disappearances. And a lot of the women who we met and heard about are really worried for their sons, the young men in their families, and being picked up by the police, rounded up, taken away. The next day, apparently, the lists are put up in the DC office. So there are throngs of women around these places trying to find out where their sons have gone. And women are actually following these stories, except local journalists are unable to publish these stories in local media. So again, I think we are paying a very heavy price for this blockade and a lot that's going on in this 1 month. Hopefully it is being documented and these stories will be told at some point. But right now, the entire picture is not emerging.
What we saw has come out very clearly in our report, which unfortunately, you know, you're not able to see, but the fact that people have been extremely, feel extremely alienated and very cheated from in, you know, whatever has happened in terms of the political processes. That is one thing.
Which people?
The second, the people of Kashmir, the people who we met. We already told you that we met a whole lot of journalists, we met editors, we met people on the streets, we met even government officials. That was what we were going to do. That's who we met. But so there is a lot of alienation. Our focus was to look at what happened with the media. And because we looked at that, we were very clear about the impact of the communication clampdown on the media and how it affected the media. Stories are just not going out. People are not able to inform others about simple things about their lives. And they're totally dependent on communication to be able to access anything at all, whether it's not just medicines or healthcare, but even schools and students getting being able to get their you know, application forms for their 10th standard exams or their 12th standard board exams. Students are not able to get information about their CAT or their applications for other universities abroad. People are not able to get job applications. They're not able to access anything. Forget about just basic personal information about one another. They're not able to get online for any, you know, economic work also that they could be doing. There's absolutely nothing. There's just no way in which they can communicate.